Hi everyone, it's Taki Nobre Des, aka Jess. You probably know me as the Crescent Moon Dance commentary YouTuber, or the Asuka sheet music uploader, or on Tumblr I'm Taki-sensei, and I'm also an admin on the Hibike wiki. So, I'm not super active on YouTube, and I've always been kind of shy about my voice, but I thought I'd try making a narrated video for once. So, real quick, I want to introduce myself and correct some assumptions about me floating on YouTube and Reddit. So, number one, I'm not a dude, I'm a girl, and I'm Chinese-Japanese-American like Orenishi from Kill Bill. Two, I'm not a high school band geek anymore. I just graduated college and I passed an audition for a US military band. Yay! So now I'm a pro band geek and I go to basic combat training next January where I'm probably gonna die, but that's beside the point. Anyway, nice to meet you guys. On to the video! Today I want to talk about Kitaoji's terrible rendition of the US Marines hymn. And also explain to non-musicians why playing music is so rewarding and fun. So, we see in the third episode that Taki goes to town on Kitaoji's performance, and any listener can tell that they didn't play very well. But most of you are probably going to be surprised when I tell you that they didn't play anything incorrectly, except for that one clarinet squeak. But if you don't believe me, I'm going to play the audio clip for you. If you're a musician, then listen closely. You're not going to hear any wrong notes. If you don't have the sharpest ears, then just take my word for it. So here it is.
Some si.
はい、そこまで。
So you can actually hear that those kids played no wrong notes. And that's their problem, because here's a better example that you can hear clearly in the trombones. Here's the audio clip.
1, 2, 3, 4.
You just heard the trombones obviously playing all the right notes, but they think that that's enough to create good music, and that leads them to ignore really important things like time and tuning. But I hope that puts into perspective just how challenging it is to be good at music. Because think about it, you could play every single note on a page correctly and still not be a good musician. Actually, there's a kind of famous college band director who explains it better than I can. His name is Jack Stamp, and he lists a bunch of things about tone, tuning, tempo, rhythm, color, etc. But then he does this really cool demonstration with the Indiana University band that's kind of similar to what we see in Hibike Euphonium. So take a listen.
So what we're going to do for you is demonstrate what the band would sound like on a small passage if we were operating somewhere between 90% and 95%. But we're going to play for you just a section of Shenandoah, with my great apologies to Frank, to Kelly. We're going to play a short section. First we'll play it for you correctly, and then we'll play it for you at 95% or so, which in most academic classes is an A. Okay, so here's Shenandoah correctly. And that would get you an A.
And yeah, that would get you an A in school. But not from Taki. Actually, if you listen again, Indiana University's 95% sounded worse than what the Kitaoji kids played. Which means Kitaoji was actually closer to 99.999% with their episode 3 performance. And that still wasn't good enough. Not for Taki and not for any reasonable audience. So here's what Jack Stamp says about that.
You see, music demands perfection. Now, we don't always get there. In fact, seldom do we get there. But it's the one few things in their lives that demands that they be perfect.
So I like the point that Jack Stamp makes, but I don't really like that he uses the word perfect. Because we see again and again in Hibike Euphonium that music isn't about being perfect, it's about improvement, and it's about being better. Look at the solo face-off between Reina and Kaori. I did a full video analyzing their solos if you're interested, and I'll put a link to it in the corner. But when you listen to them playing, it's undeniable that they're both excellent trumpet players. But what makes Reina the better musician here is that, well, she's better. She doesn't stop at 100% correct. She pays attention to nuances, she understands the role of the solo within the piece, and she makes decisions accordingly. And that makes her better, because of her will to be better. Kumika later says the same thing when she's doing her epic run across the bridge. She doesn't yell that she wants to be perfect or flawless. She says, "I want to improve." And that's just so powerful and really embodies what it means to be a musician. Sometimes we as instrumentalists just get so wrapped up in perfecting all the technical stuff on the page that we forget music is ultimately a fluid art form, not something as rigid as arithmetic, unless you're really into Baroque music, but even then there's like wiggle room. But that's why music is so wonderful as a performance activity, because there's not that many other things we do in life where we're demanded to hit 100% and then go beyond that. Anyway, I guess my point is that music is cool, it's good for your character building and work ethic, and we should keep it in American schools. Yeah, don't let anyone tell you otherwise and always support the arts. Thanks for watching this video, and if you liked it, please consider subscribing or leaving a like, and I'd also love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. Do let me know in the comments if there's any Hibike videos about music or the show itself that you'd like to see. Again, thanks for watching, and let the next piece begin. Bye!